Welcome back to my channel. You're in the right place if you're looking for anything that is low carb diet related. If you clicked on this video, you know that today we're making a cocktail. I have my Key West cocktail shirt on. And also, I have a bunch of other cocktails already on my blog and on YouTube. I will link them down below. Definitely check them out. If this isn't up your alley as far as flavors, I bet I have something already waiting for you that is something that you would like to drink. But today's video is going to be an old-fashioned daiquiri recipe. I know you might think of daiquiri, I did at least, and think of the big pink fruity strawberry daiquiri drink. This is not it. A daiquiri, traditional old-fashioned daiquiri, is actually just made with three ingredients: white rum, lime juice, and simple syrup. My husband can take credit for this one. He played around with this recipe because he loved getting old-fashioned daiquiris at this restaurant that we go to called The Bookstore. If you've never been there, it's in Bethlehem, Pennsylvania. It's phenomenal. It's just such a cool place. It's all tailored to look like the 1920s, like flapper prohibition era, and you are like, you walk into a basement. It's such a cool place, but they do all these really cool cocktails there, and they have an old-fashioned daiquiri, and he needed to recreate that at home. So once again, this is a J. Hart original. My husband's on fire lately. But anyway, the main thing here is making this low carb. And you might be thinking, simple syrup, how can I make that at home? It is so easy. So that's where we're gonna start with this recipe. You're gonna wanna make a simple syrup. So to make an easy simple syrup, it's really just a 2-to-1 ratio for water is 2 parts and 1 part your sugar. This one I like to use granulated erythritol, which is AKA Swerve. You can get that pretty much everywhere now, definitely Amazon. I'll leave a link down below if you wanna check it out on Amazon, but I found it at my Wegmans now. I feel like it's pretty streamlined in the like organic section. You can usually find it, which is where I did. All you're gonna wanna do is put 1 cup of water into a small saucepan and then add in 1/2 cup of Swerve. Now you wanna just, you know, heat this until the sugar dissolves. That's really all you're doing. That's why it's the simple syrup. It's very simple to make. You wanna let it cool down, then you wanna put it in a glass jar or in a Tupperware, and then you can put it in the fridge and it will sit there waiting for you for whenever the cocktail urge strikes. Okay, so now let's talk rum. Rum is so economical. It's not expensive. This was about between $20 and $25, depending on where I go near my house, how much it costs. This is the brand Cruisin, and it's an aged rum. It's perfect. You want to do a white rum for this drink, and like I said, it's an economical drink. Make it for a crowd. Everyone will be happy. Everyone will love you. Just do it. You're also going to need some fresh squeezed lime juice. Do not use the bottled stuff. Usually I say use whatever you have, use whatever you like. Fresh lime juice, nothing beats it, especially this time of the year, especially for summer. You gotta get the fresh citrus, because I said so. And then also you're gonna need 1 little lime, just because I feel like it makes this drink elevate to like the next level and look like you're getting it out at a restaurant. So we just did 1 little skinny sliver of lime. And then you're probably wondering, why does my glass have water and ice in it? This is a trick that I learned while bartending years ago, and how you chill a glass. So, especially martini glasses, you just fill it up with cold water and ice cubes and you let it sit, and that actually chills the glass while you're fixing the drink and while you're mixing everything together. So it's just a really cool trick, chills the glass, and it's perfect because a lot of times you'll put a cold drink from a shaker into a glass that's kind of warm, and sometimes at our restaurant they would be coming right out of the dishwasher and they'd be really hot and we would have to cool them down real quick, and this is the best way to do it. So every time I make one of like any drink in a martini glass, this is what I do just to chill the glass while I'm making the drink. And the only other thing you're gonna need is a shaker. I have literally probably 4 of these at my house. If you need one, call me. But no, seriously, if you don't have one of these, you could easily just make it in a glass and just mix it with a spoon really well, just to get the ice mixed with everything, and then it just incorporates everything and cools it all down, and then you can pour it into your glass. So this isn't a must, but like I said, I've got a few of these to spare. Okay, so we're going to be using the ratio of 2-1-1. 2 ounces of rum, 1 ounce of lime juice, and 1 ounce of simple syrup. And that's gonna be the perfect drink. And then I'll talk about later, if that's too strong, what you can do to make it even better if you think that's too strong. For the rum, you could also go up to 3 ounces of rum. It's all up to you. The way that I'm gonna be measuring is with this amazing tool. I got this at Target. They have it right by all of the stainless steel cookware items. So this is definitely something that's very helpful. And as you can see here on the inside, it tells you how much 1 ounce is. And then on the other side, it's a little bit bigger of a measure. But I'm gonna be using this side for 1 ounce. Highly recommend this as well. If you're someone who likes drinks, and you have like a mini bar set up, these two things are definitely good to have. So in here I have about 10 ice cubes, 8 or 10 ice cubes. This is just gonna be strained just to keep everything cold. And let's start assembling. So I'm gonna be using the 1 ounce measure and we're gonna do the rum first. One. And two. This is for me. If it was for my husband, I would do 3, just how he likes it. Next is going to be our lime juice. So I'm going to be doing 1 ounce of lime juice. And lastly, we're gonna go in with our simple syrup, and I'm just gonna be doing 1 ounce of the low carb simple syrup. Then all you're gonna do is put the top on and shake it up. And when I'm shaking, I usually just count to 20, and then that's usually perfect. So I'm just gonna dump out this water. Thank you for chilling my glass. I'm gonna shimmy some things around. Okay, so here we go. And then all I'm going to do is pour this right in. And then we are going to put a lime right in. Oh my gosh, it looks amazing. Here we are. I put it in, it sunk, so we're doing something different. We just put it on the side. How pretty does that look? It almost looks exactly like the one from the restaurant. Oh my gosh, let's see. Oh yeah, yeah. That's amazing. It's so simple, but the flavors are delicious if you use good quality products. Use a good quality rum. Use fresh lime juice. Make your own simple syrup at home so you can control all the ingredients. So if you taste this drink and it is a little bit too strong for you, which is fine, you can add club soda to this. So just add plain club soda and you make it into like a spritzer. It is so good. I do this a lot if I want to sip on something for a while because it can be strong. It is kind of like a martini. So if you do find it strong, add some club soda until it tastes not strong to your taste palette and you'll be good to go. If it's not strong enough for you, like I said, add up to 3 ounces of the rum and you're good to go. So this drink is perfection for all different palettes. You might just have to play around with it to get it to taste exactly how you want, but once you get it there, you will be golden. Golden. If you guys like this one, give me a thumbs up. I hope you enjoyed me making a cocktail on camera. I have not done that in a while. If you want to see more cocktails or other ideas, definitely leave them down in the comments below. Give this video a thumbs up if you liked it. Subscribe if you're new. Everything low carb here. If you're on a low carb journey, follow me. We're going, we're crushing our goals, we're getting there. So I hope you guys enjoyed this one. Until next time, I will see you in my next video. Bye everybody.